Hello everybody, welcome to episode 48 of Pokemon Battle Zone. I am your host, Ninetales Commander, and guess what? We have ourselves a doubles battle. Yes, I fancied a little change because we're actually approaching the end of season 1 for Pokemon Battle Zone. We'll be entering season 2 pretty soon, with episode 51 and onwards. So I thought I'd make a little change towards the end and give yourselves some double battles for a nice change. So, there you go to go ahead and Mega Evolve straight into a Mega Champ, and I'm going to go straight for the Flare Blitz on the Bisharp. They really should have used the Fake Out on the Darmanitan because, well, by not attacking Darmanitan, you've basically lost your Bisharp in the process. Dragao getting flinched doesn't really matter because, well, I was just going to use Scald or something anyway to attack, but the main threat was my Darmanitan, so it probably would have been better to have gone for that. So, he brings in the Landorus Therian form, and of course that means that Intimidate's going to come in. I really don't want to keep my Darmanitan in, so I know it's not going to do much damage with the Intimidate drop. So this means I can go straight into my Viridian, which definitely can take the Rock Slide from that Landorus, but sadly it looks like my Dragalge is not going to survive this turn, because obviously it cannot take a Rock Slide and a Zen Headbutt from that Mega Medicham, so sadly I am going to lose my Dragalge in the process. But the good news is that was actually my plan all along, because now I can just go straight back into my Darmanitan and target that Mega Manitram with a Flare Blitz, which definitely is going to KO, because even Mega Manitram is not going to take a Flare Blitz boosted by sheer force from a freaking Darmanitan that has a massive attack stat. So there goes another Rock Slide, and of course I am going to lose my Darmanitan, but I'm actually completely cool with that, because the whole point to me bringing Darmanitan in was to get rid of that Mega Medicham, which clearly was the bigger threat. I also do carry Hidden Power Ice on my Virizion to get rid of this Landorus. I honestly do not think that critical hit mattered because it's 4 times weak as it is, so I'm going to say that did not matter. So they've got a Greninja, which of course is Uber now, and I've also got my Mewtwo, so I'm going to Mega Evolve into Mega Mewtwo Y. I don't think I really needed to Mega Evolve at this point, but I didn't want to take any chances. I just much rather play it safe and go for Aura Sphere anyway, since I don't think I needed to Mega Evolve, but I just prefer to play it safe, to be perfectly honest. And plus, he does carry the Focus Sash, so yeah, that might have been the other reason why, but I don't think it mattered, but whatever. Play it safe, I say. Just do what you gotta do to secure the win, I say. And of course this turn I'm gonna lose my Virizion to the Ice Beam, which to be honest I kind of predicted all along, even though I didn't predict the Focus Sash. But this turn I'm gonna go ahead and use Aura Sphere with my Mewtwo and get rid of that Uber Pokemon, apparently, that is Greninja. I mean, I still don't fully understand why it's Uber, but I'm sure there's good reasons behind it. And there's this battle. This battle was actually pretty interesting because my opponent does something that I did not expect in the slightest, and it's actually pretty clever in my opinion, but you'll see what it is in a minute. So they go into Mega Evolve straight away into Mega Salamence. So far it looks pretty cliche, but trust me, what comes next is actually pretty interesting. So I have my Darmanitan use Flare Blitz on the Acelgor, but I'm guessing it's going to be Focus Sash because, well, you know, it just seems like the best holdline to have for this thing. And here's where it gets really interesting. The Acelgor uses Round. Now you may think, Round? Why would you use Round? It sucks. But it actually doesn't, because look at this. He's having the Mega Salamence use Round also, which is boosted by Aerialate that becomes a flying type move. And because the one round takes place right after the other round, it basically has priority, and basically allows for a priority super strong round that's easily KO'd the Pokemon that it just did. So that's actually pretty cool. And oh, guess what? I'm gonna Mega Evolve into 100 Mega Evolution counters. Yes, we've done it, people. We have hit 100 Mega Evolution counters. That is awesome. So we're going to go for the ending use round, and even with the boost in power, it's still not enough to get rid of my Mega Mewtwo Y, which of course is then going to die to the Ice Beam. But credit to my opponent, I actually realised that. Granted, I don't do doubles that often, so maybe this setup is more common than I realised, but I've never seen it before, so I still say it's a pretty clever strategy, considering how broken Mega Salamence actually is. but still credit to my opponents for being as good as they are. So they bring in a Mamoswine Swine and a Crobat now, and I'm just going to go ahead and see them get Stealth Rocks thanks to my Aggron. And of course I'm going to KO the Crobat with the Ice Beam. Again, I'm pretty confident that Ice Beam critical hit did not matter because, well, you know, it's Mega Mewtwo, why? But they are going to go ahead and use Earthquake, which of course is going to KO both my guys because, well, Mamoswine actually has a really good attack stat, and Earthquake is no sloppy move. It's actually one of the best moves in the game. Mind you, not so good in doubles, mind you, because, well, you know, it does hurt your teammate as well. But still good in this situation anyway. So we're going to go ahead and use Ice Shard, but I'm pretty sure I can take at least one of these. And now I'm going to just go ahead and use Giga Drain this turn. It doesn't quite KO, but I'm pretty confident with the boost in HP. I can still go ahead and take one more Ice Shard from the Mamoswine, and then finally finish this thing off with a Giga Drain. So my only fear now is the critical hit, and it doesn't happen. So that means I win by using Giga Drain, and that seals the match. So, as always, I know I say this every single episode, but thank you very much for watching, and I will see you guys in the next episode. Peace out.